Assalamu alaikum, I am Asad Yusuf. Welcome to MPT channel. Today's topic is dynamic conformal arc therapy. So it's quite similar to VMAT treatment, delivery continuously as a gantry rotate around the patient. However, no modulation as it rotates the leaves. Here you can see at each gantry angle the shape of the PTV acquired, no modulations there. At first glance, seem like a watered down the version of VMAT. It may confer advantages both dosimetrically and in planning. So VMAT IMRT treatment involve modulation, which leads to a higher overall dose to the healthy tissue as compared to 3D CRT. This is not such a huge problem in traditional fractionation scheme, but in SRT, this could potentially lead to a serious complication. So extremely small field employed in the modulated technique have large uncertainties associated with them. One should verify the small field for their own systems. So the dose as calculated by treatment planning system may not what it's delivered in small field. DCAT avoid both issues as it field always encompass the whole tumor and has been shown to use less monitoring unit. That is less dose. An additional benefit is that DCAT is also very easy to plan on the TPS, whereas the VMAT IMRT use considerably resources and time to create. So I don't know how many of you have heard about dose and dynamic conformal arc therapy. This option is available in Eclipse. If you have a hardware and arc therapy is allowed on the machine, you can simply create this plan DCAT. There are some studies comparison with 3D conformal volumetric arc therapy for small lung cancer. So these are the plans I have made just to learn how DCAT works. And here you can see the pelvis case. Conformity is not good as compared to VMAT, of course, but it gives a circular dose distribution. Major difference is monitoring units, 2 to 33, whereas in VMAT, you're giving 600. If you talk about the DVH, yes, it has higher dose on rectum and bladder as compared to VMAT plan. And similar results on the femoral head, higher as compared to VMAT plan. But you can see the sharp fall off of the PTB. Whereas if you compare with the 3D CRT, the major difference is on the femoral side. As the 3D CRT give higher dose to the femoral. But as if you talk about the rectum or bladder, the low dose region is better in 3D CRT as compared to DCAT, but the higher dose region is lower bit in the end. And the same result in the bladder as well. And this is a traditional dose distribution four field box here. And the mu's are 270. Another case, a palliative C spine case. And this is a DCAT, and this is the VMAT plan. And the monitoring units here can see the difference. If the dose is 400, the monitoring unit is quite high for the BMAT plan as compared to DCAT plan. But in 3D CRT, we use enhanced dynamic wedge, so increase monitoring units. So this shows that the DCAT would be better. But remember, the low dose region is higher as compared to 3D CRT in DCAT. So this is a video. Which I want to play. Here you can see the volume is in compass and the arc is going around. It's quite simple to insert the plan. Insert simply arc the way you insert the arc for the VMAT. Simply insert the arc and but go without going on optimization, fit the MLC to the PTV and then calculate the plan. These are the three simple steps and the plan is ready. For the normalization, you can do whatever the best suit for your plan. This is an esophagus plan. And you can see the conformity as compared to 3D CRT plan. But again, the distribution, the low dose region is better in 3D CRT as compared to DCAT. The high dose region is better in the DCAT. This is a SRS plan, and it's a test plan. It's not delivered on the patient. This is a DCAT plan, and this is a VMAT plan. So you can see the similar dose distribution. Not a big difference, but the big huge difference is a monitor unit. So DCAT gives lower monitor units as compared to VMAT plan, which gives around 2500 monitor unit against 850 centigrade dose. So one can consider the DCAT for the SRS if the target is quite circular and homogeneous. One can give a try, but of course the patient specific QA and every QA is important before doing anything new. So the summary of this presentation, use it with caution. Low dose pill is high as compared to 3D CRT, but conformal. Conformity may be better for circular and homogeneous targets, less monitor unit compared to VMAT and 3D CRT wedge plans. Beneficial in a single target for SRS. That can be considered. My preference will be palliative cases or SRS small lesions. It can be used with a combination of 3D CRT wedge or normal fields. Option of weight can be used. So you can distribute the weight among the open field and the conformal field or the simple static 3D CRT field combination with arc. That gives more conformity, and it can if you talk about the region which we are living, we need economical treatment for the patient. So DCAT would be the option that could be used as a 3D CRT concept. So this is an option. Thank you very much for listening, and be happy to answer your questions if you put your questions in the comments. And I also share the link in which the process was shown how to create a DCAT plan, because I have already uploaded the video, short video, how to make a DCAT plan. And you can visit my channel to see that option. Thank you very much for listening. I'm signing off.